Institute of Human Genetics was founded in 2000 at the Technical University of Munich and the Helmholtz Center in Munich. There are about 30 people in the institute, about 50-50 at the clinical institute in town and research institute here at the Helmholtz Center. The focus at the clinic is counseling and human genetics clinical work.
We see around 600 patients, most of them are children with monogenic disorders. We offer genetic analysis which covers the whole spectrum of human genetics, so karyotyping, array analysis, Sanger sequencing, exome sequencing, genome, transcriptome.
As a university medical center, we get referred a lot of patients with severe neurological symptoms where no doctor knows the cause of these severe symptoms. And with the new high throughput technologies, e.g. exome and whole genome sequencing, we are able to identify a cause in 50% of these patients.
In 10 to 20% of these patients, this diagnosis really needs to a change in treatment. And this can be a specialized diet, or it can be treatment with special food supplements like vitamins. And often this is really a change for the patients, and it makes major change in their life and in their quality of life. What is unique about our department, I think, it's really this close collaboration between the clinicians and the people in the lab, and that we have very good lab facilities, and this drives our research. I'm the pediatrician seeing the patients, and I'm also doing the genetic analysis at the lab and can go back to my patients with these ideas of treatment and treat the patients.
We are trying to work as much as we can together with the clinicians. We see the patients together, we discuss them in meetings, in boards, in teleconferences. Then we decide together what the appropriate genetic test is. What's also unique is that we are only medical doctors. Being a medical doctor helps you very much to interpret the clinical picture. What we're trying to do is to implement novel sequencing technologies such as RNA sequencing, which is not a routine diagnostic test at the moment. We're also trying to implement polygenic risk scores into routine tests. We're sequencing roughly 1,500 cases in a diagnostic context and the same amount in a research context.
We have a very close collaboration between the Institute of Neurogenomics and the clinic. And we are very much interested in two disorders. First, a complex genetic disease, which is restless leg syndrome. And second, a rare disorder called dystonia. So we are in-depth phenotyping the patients with restless leg syndrome. And then we have access and we get all biosamples of the patients. And this place here is very unique because we have easy access to all omics platforms. First of all, of course, the large-scale sequencing facilities, but there is very easy access to all other omic technologies, and that's very important for my research.
So my group is working on metabolic disorders, specifically mitochondrial disorders. We have also organized a network in Germany, mitochondrial network for mitochondrial disorders, and I'm also coordinating a European network. And altogether, we may cover about 10,000 patients. We have a large sequencing facility, so we have sequenced more than 2,000 cases with mitochondrial disorders. We have a bioinformatic pipeline, but we also have collaborations with bioinformaticians to develop new tools, for example, RNA sequencing, and develop new methods for the analysis of RNA-seq data in order to discover mutations which are intronic or intergenic. More recently, we developed a protocol for proteomics. We have now also started to metabolomics to validate genetic findings or to guide a deeper investigation in certain genes in order to find the cause of a disease.
We have established close collaborations on a national basis with video conferencing, discussing cases in the diagnostic context. And we managed to get a genome project, one of the first ones in Germany, the first one on rare disorders of this size. The Bavarian Genome Project has three elements. One is recruiting patients, mainly young patients, children with severe monogenic disorders or suspected monogenic disorders. We are collecting trios, and we are not only trying to collect blood, but also other tissues like skin biopsies for omics investigations and for establishing cell lines. And the recruitment is done at 5 university places throughout Bavaria. We are doing the sequencing at one place here at the Helmholtz Center. And the third is a IT infrastructure which enables a web-based access from all the 5 participating centers. I hope in the end that we get a critical size together, these university departments, in order to compete nationally and internationally, because it needs this infrastructure in the future in order to provide the right diagnostic background for these people with monogenic disorders. And at the same time, it needs sharing this data. It needs infrastructures embedded in a larger infrastructure from Bavaria to Germany, from Germany to Europe, from Europe into a global infrastructure. I think that's the most important aim of this project.